electrostatic. It is a branch of physics which deals with the charge which is in rest or in motion and energy associated with it. That means electrostatic. In electrostatic, we will study about the charge जो रेस्ट में रह सकता है या मोशन में रह सकता है और उसका क्या एनर्जी है, चार्ज एंड इट्स एनर्जी. नाउ इन दिस डेफिनेशन ए न्यू टर्म चार्ज इज ऑब्जर्व. व्हाट इज देन, व्हाट इज चार्ज? इंटीग्रल मल्टीपल ऑफ फंडामेंटल पार्टिकल, पार्टिकल्स सच एज इलेक्ट्रॉन, प्रोटॉन, पॉजिट्रॉन, ईटीसी. देर आर टू टाइप ऑफ चार्ज. फर्स्ट पॉजिटिव चार्ज, दिस विल डेवलप ड्यू टू लॉस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. एंड नेगेटिव चार्ज डेवलप due to gain of electron. That means electron is most responsible for a factor for the development of charge. Now, how charge can be produced? The second topic, first charge. How charge can be produced? Charge can be produced by four ways. Charge can be produced by four ways. First, by friction. Second, by conduction. Third, by induction. Fourth, by polarization. There are four ways to develop charge on the surface of the body. First, by friction. When two bodies, let A and B are two bodies, rubbed against each other, opposite nature of charge will develop on their surface. When two body rubbed against the, both the body must be insulator. Must be insulator. When two body rubbed against each other, opposite nature of charge will develop. If positive charge develop on A, then negative charge will develop on B. Both type of charges can be produced. Both types of charges can be produced. Amount of charge will be same. If Q amount of charge will develop on A, then minus Q amount of charge will develop on B. Amount of charge will be same. Will be same. Nature will be opposite. Student, you may ask question here: why A becomes positively and B becomes negatively? It may be possible that B become positive and A negative. This is possible if and only if the body which have less ionization energy will become positively charged, and more ionization energy, having more ionization energy, will become negative charge. The body which have less ionization energy will become positively charged and vice versa. Do you think their amount of mass will also transfer with the transfer of charge or development of charge? This question may be asked in the board exam, sir. Kya mass bhi transfer hoga? If one body if equal have mass after development of charge, do you think they have different amount of mass? A have more mass or B have more mass? Then question, the answer will be, the mass will also transfer will also transfer with the transfer of electron. Second, there is a series, skin of man or cat, fur, feather, wool, flannel, hair, flannel, glass, silk, cotton, plastic, nylon, paper, polythene, rubber, wood, resin, amber, and ebonite. The first will become positive and second negative. It can be explained, इसको explain कर सकते हैं. जैसे अगर हम फर को ग्लास से रब कर रहे हैं तो इस पूरे सीरीज में फर पहले आया, ग्लास बाद में आया. सो फर विल बिकम पॉजिटिव एंड ग्लास विल बिकम नेगेटिव. कॉटन इज रब, व्हेन कॉटन इज रब विद ग्लास इन दिस सीरीज, कॉटन कम्स लेटर आफ्टर ग्लास, देयरफॉर कॉटन विल बिकम नेगेटिव एंड ग्लास विल बिकम पॉजिटिव. In this series, you can determine which one will become positively charged and which one will become negatively charged. In this way, we can develop charge on their surface by friction. The second property is by, here, second property by conduction. When two body rub against each other, is the friction. And when uncharged body is kept in contact with the charged body, same nature of charge will develop on their surface. This is called conductional electricity or electricity by distribution. Charge development of electricity by the distribution. So first, same nature of charge can be developed. Same nature of charge will develop. Dusra, amount of charge depend on shape and size. Depend on shape and size. If they are identical, charge will be equally distributed. Third one, amount of charge. Third, positive charge always flow from high potential to low. Low follows conservation theory of charge. Conservation theory of charge. After distribution, potential will be same. Distribution, potential will be same. In conduction, same nature of charge will develop on the surface of the body. Amount of charge depend on shape and size. They are identical charge. If they are identical, charge will be equally distributed. Agar identical hai, to charge equally distributed hoga. Positive charge always flow from high potential to low and negative low to high. And vice versa, you can say vice versa. Vice versa. And follows conservation. After distribution, potential will be same. Now third one is induction. Induction. When uncharged body kept close to the charged body, conductor, especially it is true for conductor, So negative charge will develop on nearer face and positive charge will develop on far face. If the amount of charge is Q, then negative will be also minus Q and plus Q. Amount of charge will be same. Inside the conductor,
inside the conductor Q is zero, E is zero, E for electric field and V is zero also, V per potential.
This is the process of induction. It is true for only conductor. Fourth one is insulator. Fourth one is polarization. Charge can also be produced by polarization. When uncharged insulator body, polar or non-polar, kept close to the charged body, negative charge will develop on the nearer face and positive on the far face. If Q is the amount of charge, then minus Q dash and plus Q dash charge will develop on their surface. Nearer face have negative charge and far face have positive. This process is called polarization. It is true for only insulator, whether polar or non-polar. Inside the insulator, E is not equal to 0, B is not equal to 0, Q is not equal to 0. Inside this insulator, E is not equal to 0, B is not equal to 0, Q is not equal to 0. In this way, these are the four processes by which charge can develop on the surface of the body. Now, the third topic is properties of charge. The most important property is the conservation theory of charge. First one, conservation theory of charge. Charge neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be transferred from one body to another body. Net charge of the isolated system will remain constant. This is explained by an example. Uranium-92-235 collide with slow moving neutron, they get krypton, barium, 3 neutron plus energy, 36, 56, 92, 141. The charge of left hand side is equal to charge of right hand side, even in the atom bomb reaction. Hence we can say charge neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be transferred from one body to another body. Net charge of the isolated system remains constant. If this is the inverse, this room is the inverse, then we can say charge can be increased. Positive and negative charge can be increased, but net charge remains constant. When two bodies rubbed against, when tail and hair is rubbed against each other, then it will become negatively charged and hair will become positively charged. So in this room, positive charge and negative charge is increased, but net charge of the system will remain constant. This is the conservation theory. Now, second property is the quantization of charge. Quantization of charge. Charge present on the surface of the body will be the integral multiple of fundamental particles such as electron, proton, positron. And Q is equal to plus minus N E, where N is equal to 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Discussion. This theory says that charge is discrete in nature. Second, number of electron never be in fraction. Third, nobody have a charge less than charge of electron. Have a charge less than charge of electron. These are the property, but in each discussion, each point, a question is raised. First, charge is discrete in nature, then why it is considered to be continuous. This question may be asked in the board examination. If charge is discrete in nature, then why it is? If charge is discrete in nature, then why it is considered to be? Why it is considered to be continuous in macroscopic level? The second question is raised, the number of electron never be in fraction, but the new concept is quark. Actually, there are six type of quark. First, a spin quark, charm quark, left quark, right quark, fifth, up quark, sixth and down quark. In electrostatic, we discuss only up quark and down quark. The up quark is +2e/3 and down quark is -e/3. It is denoted by U and it is denoted by D. Both the quark in fraction, then why it is not considered as a fundamental quantity? Because within 10⁻⁶ seconds, they are combined with each other and form another fundamental particle combined with each other and form fundamental quantity such as electron, proton, neutron. The question may be asked in NCERT is also given, what is quark and how proton, neutron, electron are formed by the quark. So this question may be asked in the board examination. First, we discuss about the electron. Electron is formed by 3 down quark, -e/3 is equal to minus e. Neutron is formed by two down and up, one up quark, -e/3 +2e/3. This is zero. And proton is formed by, distribution is formed by two up quark and one down quark. 2e/3 +2e/3 -e/3 is equal to e. In this way, the quark is not considered as fundamental quantity, but charge may be in fraction. Disobey the quantization theory of charge. The third one, like charge repel each other and each other, and unlike charge attract each other. This is also failed inside the nucleus, because proton inside the nucleus attract each other while both have same nature of charge. But and the second case, if one of the charge body is very large compared to other, whether they have same charge or opposite nature of charge, they will attract each other. So this property is also failed inside the nucleus and in macroscopic, one of them is macro and other is micro. Fourth properties, it does not depend on speed. Fifth, charge always reside
on the outer surface of conductor. Of conductor. May inside insulator. न्यूटन इसको एक बटरफ्लाई नेट द्वारा चेक किया, एक्सपेरिमेंटली देखा, एक धागा था, जब इसमें इसको रब किया तो इसके ऊपर चार्ज था, और जब धागा का स्लीप के तरह से उलट दिया, इस तरह से आ गया, धागा ऐसे आ गया, तो देखा फिर चार्ज अपर सरफेस पर ही है, इसे पता चलता कि चार्ज ऑलवेज रिसाइड ऑन द outer surface of the conductor. This is first of all done by the Newton. Sixth property, charge density will be maximum at the pointed surface. Charge density will be maximum at the pointed surface. So, leakage of charge also occur from that surface. You can explain it by this example. ये clear हो जाएगा इसके आधार पर इस example से. मानते हैं कि sphere है जिसमें कहीं भी pointed surface नहीं है. एक जब शांत रूम में अगर हम एक candle को रखते हैं तो उसका flame एकदम सीधा रहता है. लेकिन जब इसी तरह का experiment में एक surface को pointed कर देते हैं और उसके सामने मोमबत्ती के फ्लेम को रखते हैं तो मोमबत्ती का फ्लेम सीधा ना रह करके तिरछा चला जाता है इस तरह से. तो चार्ज उसके ऊपर स्प्रे करता है. दिस इज कॉल्ड कोरोना डिस्चार्ज. CORONA कोरोना डिस्चार्ज जो भी आजकल फैला हुआ है. कोरोना डिस्चार्ज वही वाला स्पेलिंग है कोरोना डिस्चार्ज. और पॉइंट एक्शन ड्यू टू दिस रीजन थंडरिंग ऑल्सो अकर ऑन द अर्थ सर्फेस. दीज आर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ चार्ज. और फोर्थ प्रॉपर्टी आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू कूलम्स लॉ. नाउ वी विल टीच यू कूलम्स लॉ. व्हाट इज द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ कूलम्स लॉ. व्हेन टू पॉइंट चार्ज बॉडी charged body separated by distance it will experience force. Force, this force is directly proportional to product of the magnitude of the charges and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. Let Q1 and Q2, two point charges separated by distance R. Then F is directly proportional to Q1 into Q2, mod, Q1 mod, Q2 mod, and F is inversely proportional to R square. From first and second, F is directly proportional to Q1 into Q2 by R square. That is, F is equal to K Q1 into Q2 by R square, where K is constant. F is equal to K Q1 into Q2 by R square. The value of K is 1 by 4 pi epsilon. This is called epsilon. Epsilon. Absolute permittivity of medium. Unit, SI unit न्यूटन माइनस वन मीटर माइनस टू कूलम्ब स्क्वायर. तो एफ इज इक्वल टू वन बाई फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन क्यू वन इंटू क्यू टू बाई आर स्क्वायर फॉर एयर और वैक्यूम. एप्सिलॉन इज इक्वल टू एप्सिलॉन नॉट वैल्यू 8.85 इंटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 12 न्यूटन माइनस वन मीटर माइनस टू कूलम्ब स्क्वायर कॉल परमिटिविटी ऑफ फ्री स्पेस. एफ एयर इज इक्वल टू 1/4 पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट क्यू वन इंटू क्यू टू बाई आर स्क्वायर. दिस इज इक्वेशन वन. वेयर 1/4 पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट इज इक्वल टू 9 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 9 न्यूटन मीटर स्क्वायर कूलम्ब माइनस 2. इन द केस ऑफ मीडियम एप्सिलॉन इज इक्वल टू एप्सिलॉन नॉट एप्सिलॉन आर. वेयर एप्सिलॉन आर इज कॉल्ड डाइइलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट. Its value lies between 0 to infinity. Air for air, epsilon r is equal to 1. For metal, epsilon r is equal to infinity. Does not have unit and dimension. Does not have unit and dimension. इसका यूनिट और डायमेंशन नहीं होता. इसका वैल्यू 0 से लेकर 1 से लेकर इन्फिनिटी के बीच लाइज करता है. We can say F medium is equal to 1/4 pi epsilon naught epsilon r Q1 into Q2 by r square. This is equation 1. The first is divided by second. F air by F medium is equal to epsilon r. Hence we can define dielectric constant. It is the ratio of force between two charged body separated by a distance in air to the force between same charged body separated by same distance in medium. In this way, Coulomb's law is over. Now we'll further class. We can discuss about the vector form of Coulomb's law. अगर ये वीडियो आपको पसंद आया है तो please सब्सक्राइब कीजिएगा, क्योंकि आपका सपोर्ट से ही हम आप फर्दर वीडियो बना सकते हैं और हमको अच्छा भी लगेगा फिर फर्दर वीडियो बनाने में. और हमको पता है आपको इससे फायदा होगा अगर आप ध्यान से पढ़ते हैं तो. बोर्ड और कंपटीशन दोनों का बताएंगे अगले वीडियो में. सो प्लीज सपोर्ट मी, सब्सक्राइब मी, बेल आइकन दबाइएगा तो आपको नोटिफिकेशन हर एक वीडियो का मिलते रहेगा.